वेस्टर्न बॉर्डर एज द रेवोल्यूशनरी वॉर वॉन इन 1781 द फर्स्ट मेजर मूवमेंट वेस्ट ऑफ द एपेलिकेचेन माउंटेन्स बिगेन इन द पेंसिल्वेनिया वर्जीनिया नॉर्थ कैरोलिना द पॉइनर्स प्लेस देमसेल्फ इन अ वॉलेस समवट लीड और मोस्टली सिंगल रूम लैग लॉग कैबिन द फर्स्ट फूड सप्लाई केम फ्रॉम डीर पोल्ट्री एंड अदर स्मॉल गेम हंटर्स बेरिंग ऑर्डिनरी फ्रंटियर क्लॉथ लीदर ब्रीचेस मकाउ चैन फर हैड्स एंड हंटिंग शेड्स एंड टायर्ड विद अ बेल्ट फ्रॉम वेयर अ हंटिंग नाइफ एंड शूट पाउच हंग ऑल एट होम दिस पॉइनर प्रेजेंटेड अ यूनिक पैटर्न बट सून ही है ओपन अ पैच इन द फॉरेस्ट और ही ग्रू कॉर्न वीट फ्लैक्स tobacco and other products, even fruits. In a few years, the pioneer added bandit, sheep and cattle. Perhaps in a pursuit of it, the horse, home, spin, customs replaced animal skins, the more anxious clergy become more devastating with a decent life and then tore themselves off the route and move 50 or 100 miles further west. In 1788, North American lawmakers established Meritia Ochoa as the first permanent American settlement in the Northwest Territory. By 1813, the western frontier had reached the Mississippi River. South Louisiana, the largest city on the Mississippi border, or a gateway to the westbound travel and to the Mississippi River, was a primary trading center for traffic and domestic trade. There was a great deal of agreement on the need to settle new areas quickly, but this debate ignored the cost or the government should. Conservatives and Whig types by the President John Quincy Adams wanted a moderate pace that paid enough money to pay federal government spending on the newcomers. Democrats, however, endures the will struggle for land at an extremely low cost. The final resolution came in the Homestead Act of 1862 with a moderate pace which gave settlers 160 acres free after working for 5 years from the 1770s to the 1830s. The pioneer moved to a new land that extended from the Kentucky to Alabama to Texas. Most of the farmers were the ones who moved to the family groups. The historian Louis M. Hacker showed how wasteful the first generation of the pioneer was. They were also unaware of cultivation the land properly. When the natural fertility of the Virginia land was used, they sold and moved to the west to try again. Hacker explains it in the Kunki about 1812. The fields were sold cleanly for 10 to 50 acres, had long houses, peaches, and sometimes apple orchard were enclosed in fences and had enough timber for fuel. The land was sown in wheat and maize, which were important, while growing quantities of hemp were being cultivated in the fertile bottom of the river. Yet overall, it was an agricultural society with no skill or resources. He committed all the sins that characterize the useless and ignorant. The grass seed was not sown for grass, and as a result, the animals of the field had to take care of themselves. The fields were not allowed to lie in the pasture. The same crop was planted in the soil until the earth was finished. Fertilizers was not returned to the field. Only a small part of the field was brought under cultivation, with the rest being allowed to stand in the wood. The cultivation equipment was ugly and clumsy. Only very few, many of them, are being manufactured on the farm. It is clear why the American border settler was constantly in this movement. He was not afraid to come too close to the comforts and obstacles of the civilized society that inclined him into a permanent activities and are not mere a profitable one. Opportunity to sell the oncoming wave. It was his west land that drove him away. Was hungry, the farmer ignored his inadequate facilities for the cultivation, his limited means of transportation. After his landscape, he can only succeed with the virgin soil. The second wave of the settler reoccupied the land and repaired the damage and implemented more sustainable agricultural acre added.